Starting live.
The Beagles is really good.
You got two people watching.
We're not allowed to use it.
I can't zoom in. I can barely see the park in the video. Yeah. We could have some action shots down there. Maybe? Yes. Go on, Rosanna. Oh, yes. Oh. Wow.
Speaking of using the body, Zach Amros, he's really changed. Looks a little different at this game than I've seen him all year.
Thank you.
That's Rosanna. Oh wait, no, that's not. Oh, so close.
Close, but no cigar.
Cara, there's five people watching now. I think I caught you as well.
Didn't hear us.
No idea.
Pardon? That's what I want to do. Oh, but I want to commentate the whole time.
Come on, Ross.
Oh. Let's go, Rossy.
How long do they have till it's offside?
Oh. The banger herself picking up the puck off the eagle. Good night, Jim Kite. That's icing. Never mind. Allegedly not. There it is. Delayed icing.
What's the best tactic for this? Because right now I'm just trying to follow the puck.
Yeah.
I can't see it, so I'm like turning with my body. Is that Raft? He's 21?
Good view.
Pius, I think.
That's the drop. Rafter back to Kenny, the goalie himself. Little tiny baby clap bomb from the point. Alright. You got Ross. Offside, offside! Everybody's happy.
There's questions.
Oliver is playing, but the real question is, where is his accent from? Your guess is as good as ours.
Elgin. Same place as me.
Did you catch that, Alistair? Ollie's playing. And honestly, him and I are fighting.
He's on the bench at the moment, isn't he?
He's on the bench.
Uh-huh.
Keeping the pine warm for the rest of the team.
Yep.
No, he actually had quite a good shift earlier.
Yeah, he did. Ages he was on. Ooh.
Oh,
Andrew.
Downtown. Andy from Chi-Town dropping a little Irish girl. Like it's his job.
Are you just doing it for the live?
For that.
Yeah. Ooh.
Oh, another clap bomb that didn't go as planned from the goalie playing defense, Kenny.
Rebecca Gray Gardner is wondering what the score is, so are we.
Score is all O's. Bunch of goose eggs for the boys and girls. Do we have confirmation they can hear this?
I have no idea. Please message if you can hear us.
Must be some wet ice or banana peels because the people are on the ground and the puck is following them.
I think we set foot on the ice a minute after it dried.
So we've got the Irish Mamba here, bringing the puck up the ice.
Yeah.
Kirsty, a local cat. Bringing it right on back down, almost getting it out the end. A lot of back and forth in the neutral zone, but not a lot of outcome for the kids.
I know. Oh!
Shots on Phil. He's loving it. Loving every minute of it. James up here going for the rush like he owns the gym. He prefers Jimbo, but I told him I can't do it. I gotta call him James.
Wait, you're talking about me?
No, I'm talking about James,
Nelson.
We got a 2-on-1 here with the grafter.
I know. Oh, that was a close one.
Good night, Jim Kite.
Yeah. I think they can hear us. We just got...
And I am sad to say, despite the effort from the grafter herself, the Eagles have opened the scoring for the night. Let's see how all the Stags respond to this.
And that's Alistair Ebdy.
Slay Oliver. They can hear us! Accent. We're a mixture. I knew they weren't from one place. Come on.
Hi.
Thank you, Alistair. Love that. Love that for you.
Would you have known that me and Oliver are from the same place?
But
same part of town.
Else too, didn't
you? Well, yeah.
Alright. The Stags bringing a little bit of fire. Oh, after that goal. You know, I will say it, and I mean this as the highest compliment. Their positioning for a brand new team is pretty solid.
Uh-huh.
It's pretty solid, all things considered.
How many first-timers do we have on at the minute?
Well, I'm not sure how to pronounce his name. Let me take a go at it. Mahata Smita. he's first. He's new.
Yeah.
Oh.
Some solid net work there by Philip. Runs with horses by marriage. Fox. Let's see if he can keep that up. And Let's see if they get it out of their end.
I think he's quite new himself.
Mm-hmm.
Aww. Good night, Chip Kite. The former skill queen, Ross Hamilton, has just brought in another goal for the kids. Don't remember where he came from, Ross.
Yes.
So we're 2-0 right now for the Eagles. Which, quite frankly, is not what I anticipated.
No. And that's Ross Gunn in number 48.
Yeah.
Late ordering the jersey, you see.
Rude, that's what that is. I think we've got a little tenacity spark now. Oh, shut the front door. I thought that was in.
So did I. I was about to yell. Oh.
Now, it's called off the icing because it went between our defense and he got pretty close.
Mm.
But we've got Ashling Hart with a little of that Galway fire getting on his dog.
Where is it? There it is.
Now it's back in the other end.
Oofed.
Who was that for?
Oh.
Yeah, Roscoe.
Hey.
Yeah, they're really slowing down. I can't tell if they're tired or confused.
Which ones?
Just the whole lot of them, all 10. I would say all 10.
I mean, it is late night. What is it now? 10:49?
I was in my bed before I came here, and I genuinely considered not coming at all.
Mm. Got the flask in my bag, just in case you need to.
Watch the offside, for the love of God.
Oh.
Keep going. Get her out. There you're sorted. Just some new kids learning the game.
Mm. As someone who is also a new kid to the hockey game.
Oh my gosh.
What are the refs actually shouting?
They'll like shout offside.
Ah.
If they're feeling tenacious, they might just shout slander. Who knows?
Mm.
But the post really came in hot for Phil there. Felipe.
Oofed. Got.
Here's my cue. Am I going blind, or has Andy not been out since like his first shift?
I'm not sure.
Can I get a shout out for being number one supporter? Alistair Ebdy, you are number one supporter. However, despite only having 4 letters, you and your family's last name never ceases to confuse me. I always want to call you Eddie, or Edby, but alas, I'm wrong in both accounts.
I like it. Nice, simple, and yet appears to be complicated.
All right, Andy.
Yash!
Oh. I would like the listeners to know I'm sick. This isn't what I sound like by nature.
I don't know. I've never heard it sound different.
It's all a facade. I do love an underdog story, and I think this could be a Cinderella night.
I know.
Who will take our dear Stags to the ball?
Mm-hmm.
But also, I do have a sprinkle of affiliation to the Red Guys. It is it's a debated thing.
What is it we're playing for again? We're playing for a little plate.
They're playing for the Celtic plate.
I would have said Celtic plate, but sorry. Okay.
Traditionally, a game between Cardiff Redhawks and the Edinburgh Eagles for the Celtic Cup, and then the Cardiff Breadhawks, the first team in the United Kingdom I ever knew about, and the Edinburgh Beagles. But since the Beagles folded, the plate has gone downhill.
Oh dear.
So we are trying to bring it back to its previous glory.
As you know, this is a resurrection night.
Ooh. Whoever wins this game will be open to be challenged by the Beagles for a game in the future.
We got a shout out to the Bread Hawks on the chat.
Yes, they are the most important team in all the BYHA. If I ever meet someone and they wake up the next morning and their jersey's gone, I have it.
That's also a Go Garrigan from Zoe Less.
Not only can he fix your sore neck, but he can also score the odd goal. Great job. Let's keep it up. Maybe see some more from everyone else on the team.
Is that 3-1?
No. That's 3-0.
Zip.
But we're still in the first period. There's tons of hockey left. I think we're almost done the first period.
Yeah,
but
I think
the clock is shaky. I won't lie to you.
Ah, oh, that's 13 people we have watching now.
Now, number 13 here, McCaskill.
Yeah, McCaskill.
McCaskill. I had a doll in my childhood, and that was the last name I gave her. Charlotte McCaskill. I said McCaskill.
Here's McCaskill.
McCaskill. Whatever the heck his name is.
Yeah.
Spelt right.
Now that we have the jerseys, I will forego saying yes!
And the Stags open up the scoring with, I think it was Amy Thorne, but now they're hugging and I can't tell who's who. So it's 3-1 for the Red Guys.
Oh, I missed that. Alistair's gone to bed.
Alistair?
Yeah, he's gone to bed.
Rude.
Yeah.
Oh, that's Laura, right? Garrigan?
Where? Who am I looking at?
That last name. Garrigan. That's Laura.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
I said that, though.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Earlier, yeah.
Obviously. My ears are covered by a headband.
I don't know. Feeling pretty warm here, not going to lie.
Excuse me, referee.
Making friends, we see.
I practiced my French for this game because there was supposed to be Benoit, one of the guys the Eagle playing. Now he's not here.
Aww. As you may know, we're trying to make the turnarounds as tight as possible just because we have an hour and a half.
Yeah, fair enough. Well, how many viewers do we have? 12!
12 indeed!
Well, some fun facts for the viewers. We have a little bit of a battle royale happening here tonight. Coming in hot for the Eagles, we have Hashling Hart from Oranmore, Ireland. And coming in hot from the Stags, we have Ashlyn Rafter from Bangor, Northern Ireland. So it's a real Ireland v. Ireland battle of the border happening here tonight. In Braehead Arena.
Well known for the BYHA podcast, am I right? Or is that just Ashling?
Ashling Harris has not been on it, but Ashlyn Rafter has.
Oh boy.
Yeah.
Stay tuned to that for this Christmas. I hear she's on it again.
This Christmas, yeah. She'll give you her heart in the form of a podcast. But she also won't. She's taken. Sorry, guys.
Oh, we have a like.
I've missed the Beagles. Roberto, we miss you. Come on,
yes.
Stag. All right, Stuart, I agree with that.
Yeah, couldn't agree more. The non-biased commentators obviously couldn't agree more.
Okay.
Yeah. Like to show off the our tech team, whatever they're called, who are down there.
Yeah.
We have
downtown here.
We have Paul and Sophie Wolford, as well as Cara Mallon and another person.
And a friend
indeed.
I think that's a gun. I think he's a gun adjacent.
A gun adjacent, yeah. Rightio. Was like we're starting to get back on track.
Sophie is from Oxford. Highbrow shit.
Uh huh.
I can't say that, can I? Highbrow stuff.
Highbrow stuff.
Kara,
I mean, it's after Watershed.
Kara here is an islander.
Yeah.
And did you know that if you grow up on an island, you likely will have a different structure to the surface of your eye than people that didn't?
I did not know
the
that.
The more you know.
Yes, indeed. Is England an island? Britain.
You'd have to be like a tropical island.
A tropical island.
It has to do with like wind and sand and stuff.
Ah. If you you're joining us right now. The score currently sits at 3-1 to the Reds. And we're in red our coats. Second red coats. Is that what we're calling them? Red
no,
coats.
Probably not. That's probably
the
not
Beagles,
PC.
That is. Beagles.
Beagles.
Uh-huh. We're in our second, what's it called, period thing?
We are in our second period, yeah.
Hey.
Oh, we've got the GBU battle here. Two GBU players, Ashling Rafter and Vicky Carson.
Ooh.
Coming in hot. Andy rejecting all that noise, but losing the puck amidst the tenacity.
Oh.
Kirstie trying hard. A little bit of bad luck in the open ice. Roscoe Hamilton, the previous Steel Queen, current Eagle.
Not a very vocal night, I don't think.
It is not. I can hear Kirstie out there.
Yeah,
I can
a
hear
bit.
Kirstie from the
yeah.
corners. Also, Kirstie, number 6'5" down here. She smells great. She puts perfume on her equipment every single day.
That's nice.
It
That's
is
nice.
Lovely.
Lovely. You love a nice smelling hockey player.
You do. They are few yeah. and far between.
Caddy is showing off his moves.
Yeah.
Expert.
Giving the boots to Vicky Mackay, who has a broken foot, by the by. A boot of her own.
Mm-hmm.
The banger herself looking for the pass. Could have just skated with it.
I suppose.
Selfless game. That kid plays a selfless game.
Oh.
There's two Ashlings on the bench, and I can hear Earl Grey, the coach of the Beagles, yelling Ashling. I'm sure that's confusing. Especially because Ashling Rafter also plays for Steel Queens under Earl Grey.
But then again, why would Earl Grey be shouting Ashling Rafter tonight?
Well, that is true.
No excuse for losing concentration.
No, and is
no
Ashling
excuse.
Hart even out there? He's just yelling Ashling. That is some rude behavior by Coach Earl
Maybe
Grey.
He is trying to put her off, actually.
Coach Earl Grey of the Beagles. Mm. All milk, no sugar. Playing a good zone game, the Beagles are. But not getting that finish that they're looking for.
I mean, I think most of the time has been spent in our bird.
In our bird. I like that phrase.
I said bird.
Yeah,
I don't
bird.
Know. Bird?
Bird?
Bird.
You said bird.
No,
bird. What did you say?
Third, like the number three. Oh!
Third, oh.
Yeah.
Yes, got you.
I guess half as well.
Look at that. Lewis was bombing down the ice.
I know.
He couldn't move.
Well-known ball hockey player. Oh, no. That's the fourth one to the Beagles.
Another fourth goal to the Beagles. We've got some games. This is a selection made by Matthew Smith. Are people still singing it, or am I stroking out?
I think it's striking out.
Well, fair enough.
Maybe you just hear the rhythm in the.
We've got a lot of black bodies on the ice right now. There must be some banana peels out there or something.
Wow.
Oh. They can't call that icing. They went about every stick it could have.
Hmm.
Come on, Lauren and Laura. Stags for life. Love that, Marissa.
Yeah.
Love your tenace.
It's especially quaint because Stags are now losing.
Oh!
Is that 2 minutes?
2 minutes for some stick play for the Stags. I don't like to see that in a young hockey player. There are candy canes. In the penalty boxes, though.
Ah, yes.
So it's a little treat. You
it's
feel
a
shame
treat.
And you get something sweet.
Sweet shame.
However, no one who's got a penalty has eaten the candy cane or taken one with them. For the
Perhaps
road.
They think it's ornamental. You should inform them otherwise.
Perhaps. Alrighty.
Apologies
well,
for the camera shake. We're doing it one-handed.
Taking their time here with the power play.
I know.
Trying to get everyone touching the puck, but Andy says, no thank you, that's not how we do it in Shy City, baby. Mm-hmm. Oh,
there's some competition for it there.
Doing a little bit of the merengue over in the corner there.
I can't even see the puck.
They're doing the tango of the hips. the puck out.
Here we go, number 48.
Stags might come out victorious with this, really eating away the penalty. I do love that. Keep it going.
Oh, and he's down.
Too bad he couldn't get the whistle and back to the corner, but you know what? He ate up a good portion of that penalty.
Number 48, Ross Gunn, am I right?
He's going to go back at it.
Let's go.
Andy's saying, good night, Jim Kite. That's enough for me.
Nice on him. He's been on the ice for roughly 2 years.
Yeah, fair enough. Oh, almost intercepted by Ross without a spoon.
Gun, right?
No, Weatherspoon's on.
Ah.
Yeah. Oh, puck has got no. It's the battle of the cages right now. Oh. Sorry you went to bed, Alistair.
Some quality.
Your relative just did something positive for the team. And he's about to do something else positive. Yo, El Capitan here seems to have a response for a lot tonight.
Yeah.
But still no response on the origin of his accent.
Most places. Ah, we have a love part react. You love to see it.
Love a little love.
If you're just joining us, the score currently sits at 4-1 to the Beagles.
4-1 for the Beagles. The Regal Beagles.
Regal, hence the red, I assume.
Yes.
Ooh, was that a little bit offside?
Oh. I thought... Oh, someone's got to get the puck at some point,
yes. That is an Andrew...
Good deflection from the net. Ollie taken... The cautious play to watch the trailer here.
Oh, yes, nicely done.
Not in my house, that's what he said.
I think I might have missed that because I forgot to turn the camera.
Well, for those of you who didn't get to see it, it was just a sprinkle of an interception.
Yes.
By...
It was more or less just passed to Ollie, I think.
By the Maple Leaf Sox gentleman over here. He said, no, thank you. We don't want any. No solicitors.
We have number 62.
And now we got the banger back out, telling Ross, if you're not going to practice with the Steel Queens anymore, I don't want you anywhere near me.
And here comes, is that Garrigan out? Yep, that's Garrigan. Ooh, we got some...
There's some tenacity in the corner there. Now we've got the Ashland v. Ashling here.
You love to see it.
Northern versus Republic. Who will win?
Woofed.
Almost went clean out.
What
happens next?
So nicely done, Garrigan.
Now the Republic has taken this, but I think Northern Ireland is... Here we go. That was a little America for you.
I know.
Let's get it out of there for a chance.
Ooh.
Nope, back to the banger. Rafter, going to pick it up.
I know, Rafter's on overtime.
She is. Pass it to herself. Because sometimes that's the only person you can trust.
There's a little bit of interaction between her and Garrigan.
Yeah. They're actually playing quite well together.
Yep. If you didn't know, this is Garrigan's first ever time playing hockey. Well, not playing hockey, playing a game anyway.
First game.
Oh. Oh.
Banana peel on the ice. Beagle lost an edge. Unfortunate, but it happens to the best of us.
Not going to lie, as a figure skater, I struggle with backwards because you can't find the toe picks because they are not there.
They don't exist. I find toe picks extremely hard to skate with.
We have two former figure skaters, not on the ice, but in the Stags team at the moment. That is Laura Garrigan, as well as Rosanna Dyke.
And
Molly Mitchell-Knight as well. Just a little bit of...
with the setup there.
I know.
Happens to the best.
Happens to everyone.
Oh, a little footy.
A little footy.
Footy from the boys.
That's good. Oh, no! Oh. I mean, that's 5-1 to the Beagles.
To the Regal Beagles.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not allowed to announce it on the loud until he comes over.
My bad.
Who was that, Soph?
That's another one for the Regal Beagles.
And here we go, here we go.
Oh. I would like to say, we also have a Kenny on each team.
Do we indeed?
So we've got 27 down here, Kenny Collins. He's a goalie by trade. Coming in hot on the line, holding it harder than Toto ever could.
Oh, yes.
Because you know what they say? I was to see that goalie move.
I know, right?
You know what they say, Jim? Love is not always on time, and that was offside.
Yes, I would agree with that as well.
One tired kid's opinion.
I mean, I believe the reason we have two refs is that so that they don't miss anything, but...
But alas,
yeah.
I would argue the Zebras are all over the map in terms of missing. Or should I say Zebras?
I think Zebra. I use Zebra for singular and Zebra for plural.
Oh.
Just to get mixed up a bit, yeah. I try to do the same with sheep, but I never find a singular Shep.
I like Shep, though. Something about that speaks to me.
Mm.
All right, here comes... Oh, my... Oh.
Apparently offside, was it?
Went offside, but all five of them looked good doing it.
Concern is how are either of these teams expected to win when they can't even wear the same socks?
I know, right? Is there anyone wearing like any matching socks? Oh, we have matching socks between Sloon.
There's that Scoon. So Scoon. There's a handful of Steel Queen socks out there.
Okay.
The majorly red and black. We've got some Maple Leaf socks. So someone's been to the show.
Yeah.
We've got plain black.
In case you were wondering, the Stag socks are on their way. I repeat, the Stag socks, they are on their way.
We've got a handful of Eagle socks. You can see the puck handler here is wearing Edinburgh Eagle socks.
Mm-hmm.
You can also see those on a couple of the other Eagles. Oh. Fair enough.
Was that another goal?
That was a goal.
I missed that completely. I missed that completely. So now it is 6.
No, folks, what? The puck does not lie. That was a pretty nice goal coming in from the Eagles.
Emily Wood is wondering, what age is this?
Emily Wood. That
what
name
age
sounds
is
so familiar
for?
To me. This is university age. So we've got the
over
young
18s.
Bloods. So we've got the 18s.
Mm-hmm.
We've got the old maids up in the stands with sore backs like me.
Uh-huh.
And then I think we've got I think the oldest.
Oldest on the ice is Campbell.
40, I think.
Who?
Is it Kenny 40?
I think so.
I heard that rumor. I didn't believe it, to be quite
no,
honest.
No, it doesn't look a day over 19.
And for our listeners who can hear us, my co-host here, Jim,
yes,
can rap every word to this song.
Indeed.
Ice, Ice Baby. He actually co-wrote it.
I did. I'm the vanilla.
Truer words have never been spoken.
Mm-hmm. Oh.
That was Kenny, the aforementioned. We've talked, there is a Kenny Pertine. That's the Stags Kenny.
Yes.
Right there.
Yes.
And I believe both are Kenny C. We got a Collins and a Campbell, if my memory serves. Oh, Kenny throwing a bow and a bod. That was a little borderline, but the ref said, pick it up, put it down, we'll take it.
Yes.
They love that energy.
Do you think, wondering what age this is for, is this what age, what's the parental guidance? Will we say PG for the live stream?
I would say maybe PG-13.
We'll try to keep it on the down low, but, Michaela just cannot control it sometimes. She absolutely loses her...
Yeah. I spend all day trying to be an academic. Then I come to hockey and I want to use a cuss or two.
Yeah. Also, we cannot guarantee that our players will keep it clean.
We cannot.
I mean, we've had two penalties already.
Yeah. And you should have heard. Speaking of potty mouths, we've got Sophie Wolford and Kara down at the... working on the tech here. Mm-hmm. And, oh, you want to hear a trucker swear? A bunch of sailors, those two.
I know. We got some dance moves going on. And we got Caddis back on. He seems to just have...
Who's on?
Caddis. He's back on again.
Oh, nice job. Oh.
He seems to just never run out of energy. I think this will be his...
All right, Caddy. No shame in the game.
Yeah. He's moving up to double figures in the amount of years he's spent on ice at the moment. Oofed.
I wish I could say I was moving up to double figures.
Do you think?
He must be past double figures. He's not 15.
Oh, did he start when he was 15? I was just talking about he's been on a long time. Yeah, I did not know.
So he's like, what, 19?
I don't know his age.
Been playing for like 15 years.
Oh, when do you start then?
I started like 4 or 5 in the Americas.
I have not been on ice for double figures.
I mean, for those of you who don't know, in the Americas, I'm from
a small place.
Yeah,
small
place. So Andy, we've got the red bucket down here.
Yep.
2'9". He is from Big America.
Big America.
The one that touches Mexico. They got a little of that heat.
Uh-huh.
I'm from America's Hat, the upstairs one. With not a lot of people, but a lot of moose.
Yeah. Not very warm either, is it?
Not very warm. But it's definitely, I'll say, our hottest days are hotter than Scotland's hottest days. Mm.
Well, actually, yeah, that is kind of true, isn't it?
So, but in those parts of the world, if you don't play a little bit of a fan on that, I'm not going to lie, if you don't play hockey, I'd say by the time you're about 8 or 9, especially if you haven't been figure skating or playing another ice sport like Rigette, you'll probably never play hockey in your life.
What was the other one? Ice skating and
ringette. Yeah. It is a mutt sport. Oh, yeah. Big offside.
A little bit.
Arguably not as pretty as when Stags went offside, but the same
Oh, this is Mitchell Knight we have going for it, fellow figure skater.
Woo-hoo!
Turns out she really likes the rough stuff.
She does. Mm. She loves to get down and dirty in the
corners. I know.
And she was down in there with young Rachel, who's now on her third season of hockey. So it's good to see that they're keeping up with each other.
Played a scrummage with her in training last week. Not gonna lie, was on for 2 seconds because she is terrifying.
Oh
no!
Felipe's not probably happy. So, if you don't know, this is the coach, Philip Fox. Loves long walks on the beach and his wife.
Yes. And dogs. Have you seen
dogs? I hear there are horses involved.
There are horses involved.
He's not attempting to play tonight, but unfortunately, our regular goalie does not turn 18 till next week.
We may wish her a very happy birthday.
What? Effort was there by Amy Thorpe, but not a lot of outcome, unfortunately. Nothing you can do about that, just bad, a little bad luck.
Again, we can point out that it is 11:16. People have already had a long day.
What?
Not gonna lie, I slept through the entire day just to be awake for this.
Morning. It was awful.
I didn't sleep through them. I just turned them off.
Little thing about D2D, but Chris Tung getting in the way, saying no thank you. So
obviously we're going into the later evening / night.
Oh, a cheeky little backhanded toe drag there by Mark. Nothing wrong with that.
That would be great, is if we could see the ball park even in like the other side of the court, as it is kind of now.
We've got another brand new skater here, going almost heavily offside, courtesy of Ross. Gets a couple points, thinks he can just put the team offside.
Oh, on the floor. Oh, and that's another novice we have in the 20. I can't see that. 12. That is Matt Smith.
Sorry, how do you pronounce that?
Matt Smith.
Yes, one more time?
Matt Smith.
Oh, I'll get it one day.
Yeah, one day. Matt Smith. Funny you went for 12, seeing as he's what?
13.
I was gonna say the 11th Doctor, but okay.
what a time to turn that song off.
I know.
Oh, body to body.
I know.
And
would you believe we're in a non-checking league?
I know.
Oh.
Felipe.
Forgive my heart palpitations, that was stressful.
Oh, I was taking a blade to the dome there.
I know.
Now you haven't heard of the boots.
It's just the stress of the game, stress of the game.
Oliver thinking about where to go with this.
Ebdy in the 14.
That sounds like a band.
Ebdy in the 14?
Yeah.
That's Ebdy in the 14.
Boards, but no outcome.
It's feeling a bit like tennis at the minute.
It is. It's a little pong style.
Please forgive me for those who have motion sickness in the audience. Now on four
uh-oh.
People.
Uh-oh.
Oh.
Somehow
that didn't go in. I thought we were goners there. That was the thing. What was it called?
I don't know what NHL ghost was looking after Phil at that moment. But let's go Stags!
Cheryl Wood wondering what the score is.
I wish I would tell ya. Nailed it. I think it's 5-1.
Yeah, I think
could
so.
Could be 6-1.
Yeah. No, I'm pretty sure 5.
5-1.
Yeah, 5-1.
5-1? The score? 5-1?
Mm-hmm.
5-1,
To the Beagles. Could use a bit of some Stags enthusiasm here.
7-1? That's a big lie from us.
7-1! My bad, missed that.
Lots of hockey left, but a buck and a half to go.
It must be getting to that time of night where you just blank out two goals. In number six, just there, it's Rosanna Dyke, our fellow figure skater.
Love that.
Mm. That is on the Stags team. Any figure skaters on the Beagles that you know of?
For those of you that don't know, Kenny for the Beagles is a goalie by trade, but pulling off some fancy handling moves. You can see his goalie work on the blue line when he bodies all over.
Terrifying. Batteries on 20%.
Uh-oh.
Matt
will not be texting his ladies tonight.
No, he will not. Unless he plugs it in
ladies
and charges
plural.
It.
Plural. Please form a queue and no fighting.
I know. There's a line for a reason.
There is.
It's a British thing.
That should be his Instagram handle.
Yeah?
There's a line for a reason.
Are you aware that Matt is cataloguing quotes from all members of the club?
We better catalog that one.
I know.
There's a line for a reason.
I mean, so far all quotes are just me, but hey ho, we're.
I'll be damned. 1v1.
I know.
And
no dice.
Coming back up.
Fancy moves. Something happened? Was that a cutting thing?
I think Kenny's going to the box.
Is that 2 minutes? Two minutes.
Yeah.
Boo.
Penalty drawn by the Capitan of the Eagles. After showing off his fancy backhand toe drag about 4 minutes ago,
1 minute to yell that. What? Oh, cool.
Oh, okay.
You give me the no.
Oh, a little fancy footwork there.
Yeah. Is that Russ Gunn in 48?
I believe that is Russ Gunn in 48.
48.
And we've got Andy back, either backing up Russ Gunn or switching to defense. But we've got the Ashlings back out again. You can see them wearing matching socks and a matching fiery passion for Ireland, but different parts of it.
Yes. Is that both Ashlings out?
Both Ashlings are Irish, but one is from the Republic and one is from Northern.
Are they both on ice?
They're both on the ice.
Oh boy. It's getting.
That's the period. Slow it down. Refs, blow your whistle or something, please.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Sophie, can you pass me my toilet? I don't have Kleenex at my house, so I have a roll.
I've moved on to kitchen roll.
Yeah.
Yeah. Just for everything.
It used to be, you can see on those banners what it used to be.
Yes. Well, no one at home.
And then you can see on the outside banners what it is now.
Very similar indeed. Very similar. I would say that they're just, you know.
They just love it.
They're trying to evoke the Steel Queens when they play. Yes.
We're in the last mile.
Trying to end up.
20 clicks to go. Let's see where the night takes us. Our American amigo.
Oh, oh, oh. Ah, oh.
What are we calling that?
Was it a goal?
It does not get much closer than that, folks. Can Chicago bury the puck this time? The Bears.
Grafter, picking it up, putting it down. Not a lot of mustard on that. Someone else had their stick on it. She said, "Good night, Jim Kite. Get that puck out of here."
Uh-huh.
And she said it again. Giving it back to Andy. He's going to
yes.
go.
Yes. Oh, oh, oh.
Low glove
oh.
side. No dice. I thought he was going to pick blocker side high.
Yes.
I think he just tried to get it off.
And we're in a familiar place again. That is the Stags' half.
Love that.
Yeah.
Oh. trying to go find that puck. But the Beagles captain slowed it down, trying to make sure that where he sends it, he's happy with.
And that's Campbell coming off after probably a long time.
That is, yeah.
Oh, and also Gunn. We've got two changes. That's Lewis Buchanan on the ice.
Oliver Banger down low.
Mm-hmm.
Molly, one of our young guns coming in.
Yes, yes.
Oh. Ashley looking for the pass, but not having a lane.
Oh.
Dumping it down deep so she can get off. I would argue that was a... That could have been blown down, but...
Who knows?
Late icing calls today.
I know. Some odd, some granted, but some odd.
Lineup, you can see they're quite deep on their lineup. They're still seem to be anticipating much of a win out of today, which
Ooh.
Is unfortunate to see. Now we've got a bit of a ball hockey lineup.
Yeah, we do.
All Phoenix amigos. Trying to integrate some edge work into their previous sport.
Do you think Buchanan needs to tighten his boots?
Quite frankly, I don't think they're tight enough. I love a tight skate, though.
Yeah, I do. In ice hockey, I think I prefer...
Oh.
I think I prefer my skates tighter in ice hockey than I do in figure.
Yeah, I like a good tight skate. Mm. Oh. The
Is
one
that
on
in?
One. Oh. Goalie beat goalie.
8-1.
No, that didn't go in.
It didn't go in? Oh, thank goodness.
In the battle of goalie in the net versus goalie in the... Not net.
Goalie in the net blind. Fair enough, he's on his home turf. Who's that coming on that? Ah, oh, it's empty on the ice again.
He's dogging it today.
I know.
They can't get him off the ice.
In case you weren't aware of our structure of the club, Ebdi is indeed the hockey prez.
El Presidente.
Yes, indeed.
He has been known. Oh!
Oh! He has been known to
he has
body
been known
slam.
To get
oh my god.
I was going to say, he has been known to request that other members of the club call him Al Capone.
Al Capone, indeed.
Because he's owning it out there. But based on that state, you know, I'm unsure.
Yeah, I'm sure indeed. Who is that off the ice now due to...
So we got a Stags power play now on the ice.
Uh-huh. I think this is one of the first times we've actually had more players on the ice than the Beagles.
Well, this is the second power play we've
Second
made
time,
on.
Yes.
We've got Effie out there hoping to maybe get some revenge, but I will say, he does not strike as a vengeful type.
Nah, not really.
I think he's just happy to be here.
Wouldn't have guessed he was a hockey player. He seems so lovely.
What are you saying about hockey playership?
Nothing. Ah, no, I just don't expect hockey players with that accent,
yeah,
you know.
Rafter. I know. What is that? What is that?
And that's Rosanna Dyke in number 6. And in 62, it is
Artyom.
Yes. No, that it wasn't a goal. Never
side,
mind.
But no love from the goalie or the net. Coming back in, wanting more. What's he going to do? Thinking about it. Shoots the gap, hoping to get a rebound. Going to the end of the corner. Mateo Smythe.
That's Smythe, yep.
In front of the net. Thinking about it with the rebound.
Something happened. I think
close
the goalie just
no
got
cigar.
No cigar. And it looks like there's a huge line change.
Yes. 10 men up, 10 men down.
I know.
And by men, we mean whatever you identify.
Yep. I think it is. Oh, no. I think that's Pias in...
All right, we got Kenny out there thinking about it. Got some space thinking about it. No love.
Oh, who's 21? Is that Lauren?
21. I think that is Lauren.
Yes.
Kinger off Chris Tarter's skates, but air peel on the ice.
Seggy on the
ice. Got a one-on-one despite the power play. Oh, backed out again.
It's a bit slippy today, folks.
It is. Ice tends to be that way.
Indeed.
But we got a heavy offside, so they may as well pressure it, but they're not.
Yeah, no, nah, it's all good.
We've got Coach Jack. I'm not going to lie, I'm not great with names, but I remember his name because I was supposed to be named Jack, but then I was a girl.
We're on 10% battery now. My brother. Oh. You know, my brother's a Jack.
Is he?
Yes, and my other brother's a Josh.
The elusive penalty kill goal. They can't be happy about that.
8-1 now?
Hey, I believe it might be 9-1.
Oh boy.
The elusive penalty kill goal. Coming from the Beagles. Oh, hot dog.
For all those who are watching, we are on 10% battery at the moment, so...
We hope we make it through.
We do hope indeed. If not, then we will be sorely apologetic about it on our Insta.
We've got someone saying, Mom, the Stags. I'm new to the Scottish lingo, but I do mean that means, come on, Stags.
Yeah, usually there would be a C before that, but...
Not gonna lie, I don't know if you guys caught that. Our friend the Zebra almost got absolutely beamed in the melon by that puck.
I think I was looking at it, not sure though.
Yeah.
Puck is hard to see because we cannot zoom in.
Oh, here's a fun fact for our listeners. This song here, Sweet Home Alabama, it was written in response to a Neil Young song. So one of the lines at the beginning of the song is, heard Mr. Young sing about it, heard old Neil put her down, hope Neil Young will remember, Southern man don't need him around anyhow. It's written in response to a Neil Young song. Neil Young then hit them up and was like, guys, that sounds love your tenas. Can we do a collab? They said, did not get back to him.
Oh.
So he wrote another song about Alabama. And the best part of it all is Lynyrd Skynyrd, the band.
Yes.
They're not even from Alabama. They're from Florida. The more you know.
The more you know indeed.
See you tomorrow at trivia, Chip.
Mm. You sound like my dad when you speak about music trivia.
Their band name is also named after their... We got some cherry picking. I don't like to see that. Band name is named after their gym teacher who made them cut their hair.
My gym teacher never made me cut my hair. But if you were wearing the wrong socks, you'd wear no socks at all in your shoes.
I think I speak for all the fans in the stands when I say you don't like to see a cherry picker out there.
My mom once ripped the pom-poms off my socks.
Yes?
Because I couldn't fit them in my socks, in my skates. I wore them to hockey and I couldn't fit my pom-poms in my skates. It was devastating. It felt like I lost a child.
And sew them back on, though.
No. It was awful.
I mean, I would have thought there was a simple fix to the problem, but I suppose maybe Canadian pom-poms, they're quite difficult.
I think it was just I just felt so bad after. Yeah.
And that was you aged?
For those of you that don't know, the young lady there in the net comes from the Republic of Ireland, Hashtag Heart. She's here today to play against our own Northern Irish, Ashlyn Raptor.
That's 13 rushing forward.
Oh.
And
Lewis
no cigar.
Her a little attention getter in the past.
I know.
Just saying.
Oofed.
I want you to know I'm here.
And that 74 is Thorpe. Oh.
Trying for two, but going to have to stick with one. One from the point. Oh.
Hey.
That's another one for the ball hockey.
Yeah, yes. Has Matt Smith scored yet? Ha! Number
12.
Thinking about it, hello.
Ooh.
Oliver again, give it a bit of a rejection, eh?
Aye, I know. How many committee members? I think we have two committee members on the ice right now. That is a social sec and the El Presidente himself.
Wowee.
How do you say his name again? The social sec?
The social, Mathieu?
Yeah, Smitte? I think that's it.
Mathieu Smitte?
Yes. Obviously not that well known within the club. Doesn't do that much.
Does he exist is the real question.
I'm sure. Like, I've seen him around a couple of times.
I think it's all a facade.
Yeah, he occasionally turns up.
Oh, keeping it in, this better be a point.
Oh!
Oh, no love.
That's Artem Turok without a name on his jersey.
But trying to light the lamp, trying hard.
I know. Oh, yes, Ebdi.
Thinking about it again, Oliver on the line. Oh, offside on herself. I've done that before.
Yes, really.
It's so embarrassing.
Gone backwards.
Yes.
But no, has Matt Smith scored yet?
Smith.
Yeah.
Mate Smith has not scored yet, no.
No. Oft.
Oh!
Ooh.
A little sneaky stuff.
Apologies.
Giving it down to Drew. Oh,
nicely intercepted. Well.
We've got some Leaf socks on both ends of the ice right now.
I know.
Drew is another American here. About to pick up the pass. Thinking about it. Passing it down to Rachel Suddy, who's also thinking about it. Passes it to Ollie, not on her team.
Apologies for the camera shake. It's just real tense right now.
Yeah, this is...
I know.
I think he's going to go for the rush. I feel it.
Yeah.
Oh, going to pass it up.
And we actually had someone call for the ball. Park. That was lovely. Oh. I'm not going to lie, one of the quietest ice hockey games I've ever seen.
It is.
There is barely anyone shouting.
Because there's so many fans in the stands.
Yes, indeed. And here we go. It's, ooh.
The draw, thinking about it. Not quite enough mustard on that. Oh, a bit of a slice,
yes.
Unfortunately.
Number 18, Wotherspoon. Fun fact, I stole his number.
Oh my gosh, who gave a laughing thing to Hate Smita?
Whoever they are, they are. They must know him.
They must be aware. Seeing Ross go.
Yes, come on, Ross.
Roscoe sending up the ice still. A little off kilter, but effort was there. Right idea. Bring it back down to another Ross. Let's all just be honest with ourselves. Scotland loves the name Ross. The streets are teeming with Rosses here. We've got three on the ice right now.
We think that was a goal. Let us confirm. Is that our third one?
That is the third goal.
And who did that?
I believe that was Gunn.
Well done, Gunn.
For all the Rosses on the ice that shift, Ross Young Gun put away.
I hope that was Ross Gun.
Yeah, I do too. Well, you went for Young Gun. Not a fan of Top Gun.
Yeah. Also, I just assume I'm older than everyone on the team.
Do you really? Wait, what age? If you don't mind me asking.
It's my birthday. I'm only 24.
Only 24. I think there might be some older than you.
Someone.
I've heard. Yeah, that Kenny Campbell is in actual fact not 19. Ooh. Nelson in the number 39 jersey, first time playing in a hockey game.
That.
Yeah.
Working hard.
Joining.
He's been out on Saturdays. In
yeah, 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 yeah.
And he's
got plenty of practice on him.
He's been coming a long way.
Did he ever skate before he started up in October?
Not a clue.
Not a clue. I don't think he did. I think he was new to the entire sport.
Brand new. Love that.
That's Garrigan as well, first game, but she was a figure skater, so...
Who is that?
In goal.
No, who just scored?
I have no idea. Watching the puck, not the numbers.
I've been trying to figure out who this person with the red socks is all game.
I'm sure it'll come to you at the end.
Kara, who is that that just scored?
For those of you watching, that was Cara Mallon in the corner, our underage goalie.
That sounds horrible. Our underage goalie. Thinking about it, no dice.
She must be our youngest in the club, surely.
She must be. Only 17-year-old. I'm sure we've got a handful of 18s.
Yeah.
I think our coaching staff are all 18.
I know. 19 myself.
19 yourself?
Yeah.
You, Jimbo.
I know, so limber.
Can't even rent a car yet, can you?
No, I think I need to wait till I'm 21. But I can't drive either.
You don't drive?
No.
Oh.
I have friends who do it for me.
Fair enough.
Oh, that was Shaw with the puck for a while.
Oh. That was Jade Morrison with the puck. She was one of the OG Beagles.
OG Beagles.
Yep.
And returning to the returning
the
to team.
Steel Queens.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, she's got the best blue hair I've ever seen. I think having cool, colorful hair is something you know, like, innately at a young age, if you can pull off.
Yes.
Well. So I personally know I can't.
Another person who's aged 18, I think.
Yes.
Lewis
Buchanan coming in hot. About to get his pocket picked, though. By Chris Dawg.
It's quite embarrassing when that happens, when it happens to you. You think you're fine going one-handed, and then someone just hits your stick out of the way.
Not the favorite part. Ollie putting in work, doing a bit of grave digging, getting down there, picking up the puck.
Oh, who's come on now?
Shot from the point. Rebound, no love. I'm going to blow my nose
again. Ow. You want to do it on the back?
That's how I'll end the game. Annie, are you okay? Good night. He is a lucky boy someday,
yes.
Okay?
There must be ghosts.
There must be ghosts. Mm. If I've said it once, I've said it 1,000 times. There are ghosts in Braehead Arena.
I know. That must be what's keeping it so warm.
Yes. Nice pass.
Oh.
Little ting.
If you miss that because you cannot see the puck, it kind of looked
the
like it.
Sixth man on the ice tonight. The post's coming in hot for the Stags.
Always nice when the post is on your side.
I know it. Love that. Ollie thinking about it. Gonna maybe go for the rush. They've got a lot of space here. The Beagles defense playing nice and high, giving them time. Artem taking that time.
Yeah, Ebji got it. Ebji on the floor.
The man pulls penalties.
I would say so, but I don't know.
Either someone's got his plate, or he loves to pull a penalty.